Good afternoon, مساء الخير. Today we are going to talk about new topic, which is human resource management strategy. In this topic, we want to know or to talk about 4 points. Number one, what is the meaning of strategic planning and strategic plan? What is the difference between them? Number two, we want to know the 5 steps which are necessary in strategic planning process. Number three, the main types of organizations strategies and competitive strategies. Number four, the meaning of HR strategy and the relationship between HR strategy and the organization's overall strategy. دول الأربع نقط اللي احنا هنتناولهم في هذا الموضوع. What is the meaning of strategic planning? Strategic planning asks a question. Where we are now as organization or as business? And where we want to be, and how should we get there? نسأل السؤال ده البيزنس بتاعنا فين دلوقتي وعايزينه يكون فين وازاي نوصل لذلك. After that, organizations formulate specific plans to take the organization from where it is now, اللي هو current situation, to where it wants to be. ده حاجة وإنما الاستراتيجيك بلان حاجة تانية. الاستراتيجيك بلانز مين؟ means how organizations can match their internal strengths and weaknesses with external opportunities and threats. إزاي تعمل matching between مواردها وإمكانياتها الداخلية والفرص والتهديدات الخارجية المحيطة بها. Why? In order to maintain a competitive advantage over the long term. عشان يكون عندها ميزة تنافسية على المدى الطويل. That's the difference between strategic planning and strategic plan. We will move to the second point in our topic, which is the 5 steps of strategic planning process. The process of strategic planning consists of 5 steps. Number one, identifying the current situations, the goals, the strategies, and the mission. Number two, making SWOT analysis. Number three, formulate strategies. Number four, implement strategies. Number five, evaluate the results. Let us explain each step. The first step is defining the current situation for the business. The organization must ask itself, what products do we sell? Where do we sell them? And how our products or service differ from competitors? على المنظمة إن هي تسأل نفسها إيه المنتج اللي هي بتعمل معاه أو بتبيعه أو بتنتجه بتبيعه فين وإيه الميزة التنافسية للمنتج أو الخدمة بتاعتها. For example, if I have a small business, if I produce and sell laptops and sell them in Egypt market, and my competitive advantage of my product is the high quality and the low price. That is the current situation of ماي بيزنس، ان انا ببيع لابتوبس ببيعهم في سوق مصر، والميزة التنافسية للمنتج بتاعي هو الجودة العالية والسعر الأقل. The second step is to perform SWOT analysis, which means perform external and internal audit، مراجعة البيئة الداخلية والخارجية للمنظمة. We have to ask a question. Are we heading in the right direction؟ هل إحنا ماشيين في الطريق الصح؟ The answer is we have to evaluate and assess what's happening in the environment. How we can do that? How we can do SWOT analysis and study the external and internal factors. Let us answer that. This slide clarifies how organizations can make SWOT analysis. Here you can see the strengths points. If my business, my small business, which I mentioned before, is characterized by high quality and low price, this is considered strength point. If also I have strong research group, this is another strength point. If also I have skilled workers, and that كمان another strength point. If I go to the weaknesses point, if I have management turnover, a lot of turnover بالنسبة للmanagers, and also found that I have large inventories, عندي مخزون كبير من اللابتوبس, what can I do? I have to make comparison between strengths points بتاعتي and the weaknesses point. This is the first step for SWOT analysis. Then I can move to the market or the external analysis and study the market. If I found new overseas markets, that means this opportunity for me. لقيت في أسواق كتيرة مفتوحة قصادي. If I found also إن هناك diversification, تنوع كبير في البيزنس بتاعي. And also if I found competitors failing, فشل في المنافسين عندي. All these are considered opportunities for my business. It's okay. هروح للثريتس. في نفس الوقت at the same time وجدت في السوق إيه؟ I found that the market is saturated من المنتج بتاعي اللي هو اللابتوبس. I found also another threat is merger of two competitors forming single strong one. في كده تحالف بين الكومبيتيتورز مع بعضهم. اتنين من المنافسين ليه. What can I do? Based on the comparison between my strengths points اللي هي الابيليتيز بتاعتي والريسورسز بتاعتي وبين الويكنسز بوينت and the comparison between the opportunities and the threats based on SWOT analysis, all organization began to think how to establish its strategy based on this analysis. Let us move to the third point. The step number four, implement the new strategy based on SWOT analysis. The organization began to establish its new strategy, such as perhaps open new two factors or reduce the number of the laptop's lines to better focus on just a few, or hiring new workers with new competencies, or firing those who have low performance. For my small business, I will open a new market in Africa to sell all the inventors of the laptops. I will also add a new product, which is iPhone and all accessories which are related to it, because there is a diversification in the market. Also, I will hire new workers and new managers to run the business in Africa market. The fifth and the last point or step is evaluating the performance to be sure that the organization chose the right direction. The third point in our topic is corporate strategy. There are many types of corporate strategies, such as concentration, diversification, consolidation, vertical integration, geographic expansion. Let us explain each one briefly. What is the meaning of concentration as a strategy? It means the organization offers one product only in one market. What is the meaning of diversification strategy? It means the organization expands by adding new product lines. What's the meaning of geographic expansion? It means take the business abroad or open new market abroad. What's the meaning of a vertical integration strategy? It means the organization produces its own raw material or selling its product directly. It means depend on itself. What's the meaning of consolidation strategy? Consolidation strategy means focuses on reducing the firm's business or size. This slide is following the same point. It determines how a firm can build its competitive position in the marketplace. For example, how Toshiba will compete with Dell, or how Pizza Hut will compete with Papa John's. There are many competitive advantages can the organization depend on it, such as cost leadership, diversification or differentiation, and focus. Let us explain each one. Cost leadership competitive or strategy means the organization is seeking to become the leader in the low cost in its industry. Differentiations means the organization is seeking to be a unique in its industry through specific characteristics that are widely valued by buyers. For example, على سبيل المثال مرسيدس نلاقيها focus more on the safety of its cars. Focus strategy means the organization tries to compete in a narrow market, في سوق ضيقة. How? By providing a product that their customers cannot get from their competitors. مثال على كده اللي هو فيراري and تويوتا. فيراري you cannot find it at any competitors, but تويوتا you can find it everywhere. This slide sets the stage for the fourth point in our topic, which is the link between HR strategy and organizational overall strategy. This slide shows the role of each department in formulating and implementing the overall strategy, including HR department. Departmental manager can play roles in strategic planning. They can help the top managers, المديرين الإدارات ممكن بيساعدوا بشكل كبير جدا في وضع الاستراتيجية الكلية للمنشأة. How they can help in creating the strategic plan. Number two, they can help in formulating departmental plans, إن هم يحطوا خطط على مستوى الإدارات بحيث الخطط دي support the overall strategic plan and also can help in implementing these plans. We want to know هنا the link between HR strategy and the overall strategy. Let us see that. What is the meaning of HR strategy? It means formulating and implementing policies and activities that produce the employees' competencies and skills which are necessary to achieve the strategic goals. HR managers have to ask themselves, what are our strategic goals? لازم يسأل نفسهم إيه هي أهداف الاستراتيجية للمنظمة. And then ask what employees' skills and competencies need to achieve our strategic goals. إيه هي المهارات والكفاءات المطلوبة لتحقيق أهدافنا الاستراتيجية دي. Then what are policies and practices will help us to produce these skills and competencies. And ask themselves إيه هي السياسات والممارسات والأنشطة اللي ممكن يعملوها to help in في توفير skills والcompetencies which help to achieve our strategic goals. So, the relationship between HR strategy and the organizational overall strategy is shown as follow. Number one, HR managers are formulating business strategy and its goals. Number two, HR managers are identifying workforce requirements that help the business to achieve or to reach its goals. Number three, HR managers are formulating HR strategies, which are policies or activities which are necessary to produce the desired workforce, اللي هي competencies or skills. Finally, the human resource managers identify the measures and the tools to ensure the new policies and activities which are related to HR are actually producing the required employee skills and competencies.